in the beginning was the Big Bang. Then after a long time and more complicated stuff, came the donut. Join us as we travel the U.S. in search of the best donut money can buy. Coming up on this week's episode of Doughnutsessities.
Before we get started, don't forget to like and subscribe, and go ahead and click on that bell notification so that way you'll get notified every time we post new content. Go ahead and share with your friends and family. Doing so actually helps us so that we can come to your neck of the woods and try out awesome places where you live. Now let's dough, shall we?
What's up, guys? Welcome back. Today we are in Washington, Utah, visiting Doughnutsville. Now this place opened in 2017 and they're still killing it. They've got two locations now. Let's dough. Made you get into donuts?
15 years ago, I worked at a donut shop.
Oh, nice. That's awesome. Well, that's cool. Yeah. You guys have been open in this location for just a few months. How many?
3 months.
And what's this machine used for?
Gonna mix the dough right then.
Yeah. How many donuts are you doing at this location?
We never count them. We pretty much count by the screen.
Yeah.
Or by the bag.
But Saturday, Sundays are those pretty busy days. What's your most popular donut or donuts here?
It's maple.
Maple, okay.
Maple bar.
Okay, I'll have to make sure I buy one of those. Okay. You started in 2017, but you worked at a bakery, was it 15 years ago or was it 15 years?
15 years ago, yeah, like 15 years ago, and I worked at like 3-4 donuts.
Yeah, and you just liked it, so you thought, hey, why work for somebody else when I can just own my own thing? I know what I'm doing, right? Yeah, exactly. All right, now let's take a look at the haul that we got from Doughnutsville. And this box is absolutely right. I do deserve a donut, and so do you. Remember to spend your money wisely on donuts that taste good. Now, let's take a look at this. So we got the apple fritter, which we saw them making earlier. That looks so good. Remember, just because it's not as big as your hand, which this one actually is, but just because it's huge does not mean it's gonna be good. I've had some pretty large ones, and I think, oh my gosh, this is gonna be so incredible. And then it's like one of the worst. So that's honestly why presentation is part of the grading system, at least for this season, because sometimes the donut can still look appealing, but then when you bite into it, you know. But I still think it's important for the donut to look appealing. I just got a blueberry one, I caved. I decided to keep the tradition by getting a blueberry one. We did the maple bacon, which they highly recommend. It's one of their best-selling ones. And then we've also got the maple, the old-fashioned, sprinkle, glazed, and then I think this one is an orange one. I remember getting an orange one, so yeah. So that one's an orange one. Now, let's try. I'm actually going to start with the old-fashioned. I've actually heard great things about Doughnutsville and their old-fashioned, so let's break into this one and see how this one tastes. It's got the nice crispy outside part, and then nice, not too chewy inside. This is really good. If you're in the St. George, Utah area, definitely stop into Doughnutsville. They're actually just right in Washington, which is just right next to St. George. And get yourself an old fashioned if that's your forte. Now the next one we're gonna do is we're just gonna break right into their regular glazed donut. This one actually looks really good, as you can see from the dough too. Nice and fluffy. The glaze is really good. It's all around the dough. Don't accept me the bottom part, but it's really good though. It looks really good. That's really good. It's not oversweet. I feel like it's almost got the right amount of sweetness to it. This would be great for dunking in coffee or something like that. Fantastic glazed donut, Doughnutsville. This is seriously really good. Now for the third one, we're gonna try just a regular maple bar. Had a few really good maple bars in my days, and this is one. The funny thing is, maple is actually not one of my go-to ones. Like anytime I go to a donut shop, I'm like, I'm not like, go for the maple bar or anything maple. But doing this show though, I've had some pretty fantastic maple bars, so let's try this. So I can see what Doughnutsville is talking about and why this is one of their best sellers. This is really good. The flavor is really good. The dough is so soft and fluffy. This is a fantastic maple bar. So again, if you're in town, St. George area, definitely check out the maple bar at Doughnutsville. This is a fantastic donut. Great job, guys. Now for the honorable mention, I'm actually gonna go with the apple fritter. It's well done. It has one thing that is actually a pet peeve of mine is when places call it an apple fritter, but it's mostly just glaze and dough. And there's hardly any pieces at all in the fritter itself. So like I said, mostly dough and glaze. This one actually has a lot of chunks in it. Just right there, look at that. Look at these huge chunks of apple pieces. And even when we saw them making them earlier, you could tell there were quite a few pieces of apple chunks in there. So great job on this. This is a fantastic donut. And definitely a great one to add to their lineup. So check out apple fritters there at Doughnutsville if you like apple fritters. All right, thanks for holding, guys. Now for the rating, let's go over that with Doughnutsville. For the glazed donut, we're gonna give it a 9 score for the dough, an 8.5 for the taste, and then a 9 for the presentation. So total score on that's gonna be 26.5. Great job on that. Now for the maple bar, we're gonna give it a 9 score for the dough, 9.5 for the taste, so close to perfection there, so good, great job on that, and then 10 for the presentation. So total score for the maple bar is gonna be 28.5. Now for the final donut that we tried, which is the old fashioned, we're gonna give it an 8 score for the dough, and then a 7 for the taste. And then presentation, we're gonna do 9.5, which gives it a total score of 24.5. So total score on that is 79.5, and when we do all of our complicated math and everything, all the algorithms and everything, we get a 26.5 score for their total. So great job on that, Doughnutsville. Super happy for you. Thanks again for letting us stop by. We'll see you next time.
Don't forget to like, subscribe, and share. And if you'd like us to check out a donut shop in your neck of the woods, go ahead and drop a comment or email us at doughnecessities@gmail.com.
Cold. 2, 1. Love you, Jade.